Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Foladara of Falsies Beauty here. If you're new here, you're welcome. You're very, very welcome. And if you've been an old subscriber of mine, it's good to see you again. So in today's video, I actually went on another shopping spree again this month. So I went on a shopping spree twice. I planned that, okay, I'm just going to be spending just once a month because, gosh, some makeup products can be expensive. So I decided, okay, let's do this once a month instead. But now I just couldn't. I had to get it. I had to just get it. So yes, the products I'm talking about is from Zikel, and it's this, their lip stick new product in collaboration with Makeup Ghana. So I saw it on their page and I just felt, okay, I might just get this and swatch it for my viewers. So alongside this, I got some of their other products that I've always wanted, and that's the Zikel 24k golden ampoule in high honey and all. Then I got their makeup spray, and I got their concealer in this shade only. I got it in this shade only. This is, I think this is the darkest shade, I'm not sure. Zikel Cafe, I think this is the darkest shade. So this shade is actually not my shade, but I have a lot of concealers that are my shade, but I don't really have for a very dark person. So I felt, okay, when I'm doing on makeup for a very dark person, I'm going to try this out. So I may not be trying this out in this video, or maybe I might, I'm not sure, but I might need to mix it up with other things, and that doesn't really give me, like, it doesn't really give me answers to the questions I want to ask. Is this product really good? Is this product something that I can use continuously? Could this be my favorite product at the moment? So I wouldn't like to mix it with another product when I'm testing it for the first time. So I may not be using this in this video, but I'm going to use the other three products to see and be sure, especially this. I'm going to swatch all the colors, honey, all the colors. Anyways, let's get right to the video. This is how it comes. It looks so yellow. Honestly, it looks so beautiful. Actually, it looks like something I can easily just take and just all right, so I'm just gonna take this and apply. I've always wanted to do this, by the way. And finally I'm doing, no, that's not where it's supposed to go. Yeah, wrong application in the first try. From how I have seen other makeup artists use it, it just always looks oily. Not oily, like, it always looks like it has this oily feeling. But right now, it really doesn't. Alright, so I just finished applying my foundation on directly on the moisturizer I applied. I did not apply any other thing but the moisturizer, and I can honestly say I like how it's looking. My foundation is not looking cakey. It's not looking like I applied something as a base, you know. I can just buff in, and it's buffing in correctly. So far so good. I'm liking this product. Even though this is not my shade, I really, really, really want to use it. I don't think I want to use any other product. I really want to see how it looks. So guys, permit me to actually use this. I'm pretty sure it's not going to look out of place since it's a concealer. It's definitely not going to be like darker than my face from what I can see. So I can still use it as a concealer, even though it's not my shade. I'm supposed to use it as a concealer. It's someone darker than me that is supposed to use it. But I really, 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 really want to see how it looks. I want to know what kind of concealer it is. Is it the type that dries out faster? Is it the type that is blendable, or is it the type that is not blendable? You know, I really want to just try it. And the name of the concealer is Second Skin Concealer. So let's see, is it really Second Skin, you know? Or does it end up looking cakey? All this, I need to find out. All right, so I'm just going to buff it in using my brush instead of using my makeup sponge. I'm just going to use this instead. And this is a Sit Pretty brush. It's a Sit Pretty brush, so it should get the job done for me. Okay, so since this is not my shade, right, I can't, please don't judge the color, because I already said it from the beginning that it's not my shade, it's not really my shade, but I'm liking it. It's blendable, it seems blendable. It's not all that creamy, it's not all that creamy, and it doesn't dry up too fast. So far so good, the concealer seems good, so I don't mind buying my color now. I don't mind actually buying my color. And I'm using the AOA Studio Perfect Setting Powder. So now that I'm done with my brows, I'm going in with my Dose of Color eyeshadow palette, and I'm using the shade Lavender Honey and Cone for my eye look. So I'm going in with the cone first. I'm just going to apply that on my crease. I decided to add hot fudge somewhere in between, but not too much of hot fudge, just a little bit of hot fudge here. Next, I'm going into my Lavender Honey. I've primed my eyes a little. I'm just going to use my fingers to try and blend it out a little. So I'm going in with the Lavender Honey. I'm just applying directly on my lids. Okay, so I went ahead to do the remaining parts of my eyes, like liner, lashes, and I also applied my highlighter off camera, since I'm focusing on this product right here for this video. I didn't really want to waste time doing all of that. So I'm going to go in to try out all of the lipsticks one after the other. So this is how it comes. After I remove it from this pack, this is how it comes. Then you open up and then it comes this way. It comes this way. I don't know if this is the arrangement for everything, but this is how it's arranged, and I hope you can see it. So there's nude shade there. It has some nude shades, and it has red, has pink, and this really deep pink also. So there's really no dark shade in the palettes or in the collection. So this is how it comes, and I'm trying this one, the Jocelyn shade. Because I have really dark lips, it could take a while for the color to really pop, but I'm liking this. It's creamy, it seems like, you know, it gives that nude color for real in gloss. Yes, I like it. Okay, so we're going into the next color now, which is Bob Risky, and this is also nude-ish, but in a different shade of nude. How does Bob Risky look on my lips? I don't know, that sounds wrong, but I really like this shade though. Like, it's so pretty. Like, this is something that I see myself using a whole lot. This I know I'm going to definitely use a whole lot. So let's move on to the next color, the next shade, which is the Sally. Is it also looks nude, but it looks like a deep pink to me. So we're just gonna clean out Bob Risky from off our lips. Bob Risky has to go for Sally to come in. How does it look, guys? How does Jocelyn looks? So for the next shade, I'm going in with Martha. I don't know. But this is the color I'm going in with. That took some time to get off, but I finally got it off and I just used the same brush I used for my foundation all over my lips again to give it some color. So now I'm going in with Martha, and Martha is also, or I'm not sure, let's try it. Oh my god, guys. If not that, I'm trying to swatch. I'm supposed to apply liner first before all of these lipsticks, but I need to see how they look in their natural state. And this is so pretty. Ladies and gentlemen, Martha here, Martha. So I'm going in with Amaka now. And yes, this is matte, so it's definitely going to be harder to take off, just like Celie. I think of all the colors, this is my least favorite. Of all the colors that I've tried, this is turning out to be my least favorite. Aside from the fact that I don't like the color, it seems to not glide on as perfectly as the other four. So, and I'm pretty sure they used sort of same products, so I don't know. But this is still my least favorite, but someone else might try it. I'm still going to use it. I'm still going to try and use it some other time. Maybe it's just not applying well. Maybe the problem is from me. I don't know. My last shade, and that's Njeka. That's N-J-D-E-K-A. The last shade is called Njeka, and it's red. Yeah, it's red. And I'm pretty sure it will be matte. For it to be red, then it's matte. This is the last color and I'm loving it. Honestly, I feel like it's so pretty. It's something I can carry just like this, you know, just like this. I don't even need to line it. It's something I can actually take just like this, and I really love it. I like it. So that's the end. I've tried out all the colors from here, everything already, and I have to say at least 5 of 6. I love 5 of 6. That's a perfect number for me. And the last one that I don't really like, is just a shade I don't like for myself. It's not a shade I would normally use for myself. It doesn't mean that the product is bad. It's just not my shade, not just a shade I like. So I have one more product to try out, and that's their makeup spray. This is how it comes. So I'm just going to, it's a 24-hour long wear and hydration. So even though it's keeping the makeup on for longer period, it's also hydrating the face. So I'm just going to apply that. Comes to the end of the video. So my final opinion about the Zikel and Makeup Ghana Fabulous Lip Collection is, it's a very nice product. I really like it. I like the gloss. I like the matte. I like the fact that it doesn't stain, that the matte lip glosses, the matte lipsticks do not stain everywhere when you use them. And I like the glosses. The glosses are not too thick and they're not too thin. They are just perfect, you know. So it is definitely Falsies approved. So that's the end of the video, guys. I really hope you enjoyed yourself. I hope you enjoyed watching the video. If you would like to try out the product, you can follow them. They have a page on Instagram, Zikel Cosmetics, I think. Just chat them up and they actually attend to you fast, so you don't have to worry about that. And if it is something, if there's a product you would like for me to try out, you can drop it in the comment section. If it's something that I can do, I will definitely do it. And even if it's something I can't do right now, I will look into it and see if it's something that I can do. And if it's something I can absolutely not do, I will let you know in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, don't forget to subscribe, and don't forget to hit that notification button, because you do not want to miss any of my videos. You don't. So see you guys. Bye.